Here's the microwave I plan on fixing up. Take out the glass plate. Lift out the spinner. Okay, and you can see here that this wheel has rust all over it. But that's just superficial. Well, I should be able to clean that off. Okay, you can see that there's rust all the way around here in a nice ring. But let's clean this up and we'll see what's actually rusted and what's just dirt. Mix up some hot water. A little bit of dish soap. Clean with the soapy water. That's not doing much, is it? Okay, we'll try some Barkeeper's Friend. Okay, that's starting to take it off. Okay, this is just water and Barkeeper's Friend. If I understand right, Barkeeper's Friend has feldspar in it, which makes it less abrasive. I don't know if you can see it, but here in the middle here, there are some little spots showing up with the paint. Coming off. More paint coming off here. So I want to get all of that loose paint off. Okay, I'll keep going with this for a while. Okay, so here you can see I really scraped off a lot more paint. Okay, I'm going to start doing a little sanding. I don't know if you can see it. You probably can't, but I can feel paint and bubbles here. Starting with 100 grit. Okay, this is after using the 100 grit. And you can see here that some more areas opened up. So now we've got some 220 grit, an old piece of foam I found somewhere. You could use a sponge or whatever you want. Now I'm just gonna smooth this down. I want to feather the edges so that when I paint this, there won't be a bump here when those wheels go over it. To get in some of these tighter spots here, I'm just using the sandpaper on my fingers. Okay, hopefully you can see right here, I just scratched off some paint and there was rust underneath it. So we'll see how much of this I need to remove, huh? Here, let's see here. There we go. I'll keep going. Okay, I'm setting up an exhaust fan here, aiming at two open windows, so that will blow the stinky paint thinner smell out the window, and it will pull in clean air from behind me. Okay, for my last cleanup, I'm going to use some paint thinner. It doesn't take much. I'm just cleaning up this dust. If you're going to paint the entire inside of the microwave, you can just mask off the vent and cover up the light. But if you're going to cover the light, it produces a lot of heat. You need to either unplug the microwave or turn off the circuit breaker that goes to it. Okay, I'm just using a brown paper bag for masking. You can use newspaper, wrapping paper, whatever you have. Start even with the edge, move it out a quarter or a half an inch. Now I can trim this even. I'll go around and do all the corners that way. Cover the vent. Cover the light over here. You still need to mask off around the edges here and then obviously cover up the rest of the oven. You need to either unplug the microwave or turn off the circuit breaker. I'm just going to be painting the floor of my microwave. So I've got my removable tape here. And I'll start
masking this off here, huh? A little bit arbitrary because I don't really intend to paint the whole microwave. And I don't think your average person is really gonna be looking inside here to see if I did a perfect job, because if they do, they ain't no friend of mine. Okay, I'm going to carry on taping this off. Brown paper bag, cut up. I've pre-folded this. It wasn't that hard to measure. I just held the bag up to the opening, and I just made it about 2 inches higher than I needed, and then I could put a fold in it, and here we go. A little hard doing this with the camera in the way, but what the heck, huh? And it helps, I think, to put the tape on before putting it in there. I'll add some more tape now. I've pre-folded this one just like the other side, but over here, so it's gonna fit in there. But over here, there's a lamp, and that gets pretty hot. So I'm gonna mark that off and cut a hole in it. Okay, the roof masking. Okay, I think you can see that as I went along sanding and scraping, a lot larger area was exposed, and I sanded it down to get all the rust off. The main thing now is I've got some fine 220 grit sandpaper, and I'm going everywhere where there's glossy paint, and I'm lightly sanding it. And once, everywhere on the entire surface where I intend to spray paint, once it's been deglossed with sandpaper, then I can mask off the entire microwave oven from the outside and get ready to spray paint. Okay, so first I'm gonna vacuum off the dust. Okay, so now I'm doing a clean up with a little bit of paint thinner on paper towel. And I'll keep doing this until it's clean. Okay, while I'm masking this off, I'm making sure not to cover up these two slots here, because these two hooks here have to fit into those two slots, so I don't want those covered up. Okay, so whenever I have rags that have paint thinner on them, I put it in the box and I put it outdoors, partly so the smell will waft away, but also because what they call oil-soaked rags can actually self-combust and burst into flames. And that kind of looks bad if you do that in the house. So you don't want to just throw paper towels or rags that have paint thinner on them in the trash in the kitchen. Take them outdoors, and in a little while, they'll all be dried out and then go in the regular trash. The spray paint has a tendency to settle to the bottom of the can. So you get solids down here and the rest solvent up on the top. Shake it until the ball starts moving. Rotate it around. Just drip paint in the bottom and then shake like the devil for at least 2 minutes. Longer is better to get this paint completely mixed up. And there's a little arrow on the top here and a hole where the spray comes out. And you want to line those up with this black dot on the rim of the can. And it's ready to spray. If I spray from too close, you can see where it's runny. It may also bubble afterwards. If I spray from too far away, I'm going to get uneven coverage. So what I need to do is find an in-between where I feel like I get a good pattern. And I'm going to be spraying a light coat like that. should really be shaking it again every 30 seconds.
Hold the can upside down and spray until just air comes out. And that clears out the nozzle. I've got this all masked off here. And so I can reach inside and do my spray painting without getting spray all over the room, right? Oh, wait a minute, I forgot. I need to put something in that center hole. I just rolled up a little piece of foam rubber here. Hopefully that will do it.
Apparently the key with this stuff is to really shake it up well.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
Just to know she can burn my stuff. Well, one great pleasure in life, huh? Tape this shut, turn on the exhaust fan, and in a couple minutes I'll open this up and let it air out. I've got some bubbling paint. I did too thick a coat the first time. I should have done several thinner coats. It just didn't seem that thick to me. Here, in a lot of places, it's holding on just fine. It's perfectly smooth, but I'm gonna have to let that dry, go in and scrape and sand that down again, see what I can do. For sanding, I just dug up a couple little blocks of wood, wrap the sandpaper around it, and then I can sand, get a nice flat surface. Okay, I've sanded down where it bubbled. Now I'm cleaning up the dust with mineral spirits or paint thinner. And I need to let this evaporate. Okay, I probably should have sanded more, but you can sand your microwave more if you wish to. There's no limit. It says, apply with dusting strokes. Let paint become tacky between coats. So I am really just gonna dust this. That is a very light spray. I'll come back in about 20 minutes and do it again. It's only been about 10 minutes, but this is definitely beyond tacky. It's just about dry. So I'm gonna give it another little dusting here. Let that dry for about, I guess, about 10 minutes. Okay, Fran, you want to come on over and take a look at this half-assed job I did?
Yes.
Ooh. Reach in and tell me what you really honestly think. I'll hold it. Okay.
Oh, it's really nice. You got all the way back into the corners and everything, too?
Yeah.
It's very
water
scrubbable.
There.
Oh, so you can show the center.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, now. You do love to throw things out, don't you?
I do. This is going to go in the burn pile.
Burn, baby, burn. Yeah, I think we will give this another day to harden and dry out and all that.
Yeah. You did a good job, Max.
Thank you.
Really did a thorough job, Maxim.
Thank goodness I didn't use regular masking tape, huh?
What kind of tape is this?
This is the expensive Painter's Mate Green.
Then I think we're good.
Okay.
Looks nice. Really.
Thank you. So. Yeah, okay. The last step is to clean this rust off of the wheels. Then I'll use some Barkeeper's Friend. There's some Barkeeper's Friend. I'm just rubbing it in here.
once around. Hopefully you can see it started to clean it up. And then indeed the surface of this wheel is kind of rough. So hopefully you can see there, it's getting clean. I'm going to clean it some more, and then I'll go on to the other wheels. So you can see it's not a perfect job, but it's a lot cleaner. Okay, so I'm just holding the wheel and rubbing it against the sandpaper. And I can kind of feel when there's a rough spot on the wheel. And little by little, I'm just smoothing it down. Okay, so here we are.
Yep, we are.
Now I'll really be able to see how the paint reacts, eh? Okay, here we go.
What are we looking for?
There's two things. The steam can get, if it can get through the paint and make it bubble, that's bad. But also, you don't want to be running a microwave oven empty. So there's some water in there, right?
Mm-hmm.
To absorb the energy. When I open the door, I'm going to feel around on the floor of the microwave to check for hot spots.
Ah.
There we go, it's bubbling.
There it starts bubbling.
Okay. And 2 seconds to go. And now, this feels a little tacky. But no hot spots anywhere. So I think I'm going to leave this open and let this dry for another day. Because like I say, this somehow, for some reason, felt a little tacky.
Can I feel?
Sure.
Yeah, tacky.
Okay.
Tacky.
That way it'll match the rest of our kitchen, won't it?
Yeah, tacky.
Tacky. Okay. And you may have noticed a piece of white paper here, which is inside the door. And what I've read is you can take off this inside panel to get in there. But so far I've not gotten official permission to do that. Maybe. Hear that? Hey, here are the materials I used. Some dishwashing soap, Barkeeper's Friend for cleaning out the interior, drop cloths, paper bags, painter's tape for masking things off. I used up about twice as many latex gloves because I changed every time so I wouldn't put fingerprints all over the kitchen. Paint thinner for cleaning off dust and when I did leave fingerprints around the kitchen. A bunch of paper towels, microwave cavity paint, an exhaust fan for getting the dreaded fumes out of the kitchen, scissors and measuring tape, and a pen for measuring how to cut off the masking materials. Here we are. Ta-da!